Hi everyone, my name is Hani Madhu for the lightandmagic.multiply.com and I'm very excited today to talk to you about Project Mgen. Now Project Mgen, it is an online CSS generator in which enables you to create your own theme in a matter of minutes. Whether you are a newbie or an expert, you're really going to appreciate this piece of software. This Project Mgen, they've been around for the past 1 year, but the problem is they've been online and offline for many times. The last time they've been offline, since December last year, and only recently on August 24th, they're back online, and this time they claim to be they're back for good. Okay, part of the problem is because they sponsor, in order to maintain their site, they have to pay money from their own pockets. So they're trying to get some revenue from the Google Ads, but they still need your help. If you have the time and the money, you just go there and donate some money there. Okay, if it is up to me, I would have multiply.com adopt the idea where to sponsor their site. But because this is what people want, this is what people are asking for: a simple software in which enables simple user to modify their multiply site, okay, in a good way that is. Okay, previously when we people ask us, is there a way to create themes? Previously we used to answer them yes. You just go to these sites, multiplydesign.multiply.com, modify.multiply.com, css4mp.multiply.com, trickmp.multiply.com for Indonesian people speaking, and also the lightandmagic.multiply.com, which is my own group. Okay, all my tutorials, video tutorials are posted over there. You're welcome to go there. All right. So, Project Mgen. Now, Project Mgen. Look at Project Mgen01.multiply.com. Again, I'm repeating again. You just go there and just read the introduction. It is maintained, and you just look at this logo. You click on it. Okay. And this site is maintained by two college students, Daryl and Darwin. Guys, you did a great job. But so far, they only have two base themes to modify from. You have a choice between Avilac and Skyline. Okay, for Avilac, version 2.5, and for the Skyline, it is 1.5 beta. Now, beta, I'm assuming the word beta because they are not really comfortable they are not fully finished with it. So, we are going to take the first example, which is the Avilac. Okay, hopefully with our support, they will be able to add more and more base themes to modify over there. Okay, so another page will appear, and it will have, this is a preview page in which it's like, in which you can make the changes there. And it will show the changes on the preview page. Now the difference between this is not a multiply page. You will notice at the bottom here, this is a yellow stripe in which edit menu, edit title, edit body, edit header. Okay. Every time you click on one of those menu items, a window will appear in which you can make the changes over there. So we just go there and just click and edit the title, and you can see the first thing is change the color. Okay, you can change the color, but if you know the hexadecimal code for pound hash mark, I don't know what you call it, for pound 0000000, this is the hexadecimal code for the color black. Okay, if you want to change it to red, you have to change it to FF00, which is the color red. But if you're not familiar with the hexadecimal system, you just do the whole thing and just type LED, which is the color red, right? And also you can change the size, the font, whether you want it to be bolder, or you want it to you want to hide the title entirely. It's really up to you. This is the great thing about it, because you can make the changes, and you are free to make the changes, but that will not impact on your multiply page yet. Okay, so after I finish everything, you just click save, all right, and you can see the page has been reloaded, and you can see all the changes have this is the name or language. Okay, just post a reply there. Okay, Because you can see the changes, it become red and it got a bit smaller, smaller. Okay, now we just make a move on to the next example, which is it is the body. Now the body, it is a black area, the black surrounding, the black area that is surrounding our content. Now currently it is occupied by a picture which is striped gray and black. Okay, I'm just going to close here and open. Okay, edit body. Now edit body, this is the color, it said here the color of the background should be black, so we're going to change it to something interesting, blue. Okay, blue, right? Once you do it, you can also put a picture there. Once you put a picture, you can decide whether you to repeat it or whether you want to fix it to a certain position. You want to put it on upper right corner, you want to put it on the upper left corner, and so on. But and also whether you want it to be fixed or scroll. Now fixed and scroll is like when you scroll down the pages, you decide whether the pages. Whether the picture on the body area will fix with the screen or just move along with the scrolling. Okay, I'm going to show you how to import the URL address for the background in a short while. Okay, so just make the changes blue color enough. Okay, now is everything's done. Now we move to the next step, which is the header. Now the header is or the banner, which is the topmost picture of your multiplayer page. Now currently the Avilac base theme, they only have this green green rose picture, in which you can replace it by another picture by putting a URL address inside there. Now what is a URL address? URL address it is an address of where the picture is stored. Okay, for in order to do that, okay, before that, you just, if you click here, this is the information box, in which if you click here, you will see it will tell you the details that preferably the picture will be this size, 760 times 200 something. But the thing is, the picture that I have in my account, it is slightly smaller, it is slightly shorter in height. So I'm going to make the modification there later. So to get the URL address of image, first of all, you post an image inside your multiply page. Okay, I already have a picture here in my multiply album. Okay, and you click the slideshow. Now once you click on the slideshow, another window will appear in which the picture that I have inside there will be zoom maximized to the full size of it. Now if you're using Internet Explorer, you need to go to a tutorial that I have created earlier, which is called how to get a URL address, because the step is a bit lengthy. But if you're using other browsers like Firefox, Opera, Safari, and Google Chrome, you just simply right click on the picture and just copy image address, copy image location, or copy image URL. Okay, you just click on this. Okay, mine is Firefox, so copy image location, and you go back to the Mgen again. Okay, and you just right click on the empty space here and paste the URL address of the picture, and you just click save, and voila. But you can see the changes. You can see the changes occurring right in front of you. The picture has appeared. It's loaded in front of you right there. So again, as I said, because the picture, my picture is a bit shorter, so I can modify the height to me. Just fit it. I think 1.4. Okay, I need to go a bit fast here, so I'm going to change a bit. I'll put the border yellow and save. Okay, now next is edit menu. I'm just going to click edit menu down here and put the active font, make it yellow, and you can change the font a bit bigger, right? Save and refresh. Okay, there it is. Right, so next is the edit content, in which the background color, let's make it green, and the border, make it yellow, more interesting, to be dashed. Now, the sub border is, I'm assuming this is the item box border, so I'm just going to change it to red and dotted, and click save just to see how it looks like.
Ah, there it is. Yeah, I'm correct. This is the item box border, right? So next, I'm going to change the title here. Just change it to white, yellow, and make it bigger. Change the font. The text is the general content. Make it white, just slightly bigger, and change the font. And lastly, the link itself. Make it red, bigger, and see how it looks like. Save, and you will see the changes occurring in. Okay, something wrong. Oh, there it is. Voila, there it is. Right. Now, next item is the rail. Edit rail, in which you can edit each individual rail start and just change it to color red. Rail body, make it. Sorry, the text is white and change the font. The background, make it blue. The rail end, just leave it alone and save it. Okay, and voila. Okay, and you can change all the footer and everything, but I'm going to jump to the next step, which is go click on get a CSS, right? And you just highlight the whole thing and click right button and copy it. Now go back to the your multiply page, okay, and click on customize my site, which is supposed to be just below the okay, there it is. Click on customize my site. Or customize site. Okay, customize site. All right. Okay. Why is it taking? Okay. Then click choose the theme. Right. Again, if you remember, we are modifying AviLac, so you have to scroll down, look for the AviLac. That is some other. This. Right. So click on the AviLac base theme.
Alright, and again you click on customize my site, you go to custom CSS and you paste the code right inside the custom CSS. At the end you click save and voila, you can see the changes happening right in front of you. Okay, this is Hanimado for the light and magic of multiply.com, and you have been informed. Take care.